October has been a crazy good month for Figma. In this video, I'm going to mention 7 features that I love the most in Figma's October 2022 update. Sections. So we all have been used to seeing all these pages where we can see a bunch of screens on this part of the screen and on the other side and things like that. And we all do this to just make sure that, hey, you can see the flow number 1 here, flow number 2 there, and flow number 3 there. But there is no real segregation between one screen versus another. So we add a background or add it in an artboard. So Figma just went ahead and solved this for all of us. Now you can select a bunch of components, screens, whatever you may like, and just, like, you know, create a sections. And you can also name the sections. So this is going to be super helpful when someone is trying to navigate through your file and they just want to look for a particular section. So they just know, hey, I have to look over here. Number 2, they have introduced music in Figjam. While you are working in Figjam, you don't have to go outside the app and, like, you know, go on a Spotify or YouTube Music to play the music. You can just from right here start a music collaboration session. So you just have to choose the music and it will play. And they have curated a very good set of music as well. So if you are looking for concentration music, slightly hip hop or something like that, you can do that right here. Number 3, they have added new frame presets in Figma. So now you'll be able to find the preset for iPhone 14, iPhone 14 Pro, 14 Pro Max. Similarly, you'll be able to find for MacBook Air M2 and TV as well. This is just a small upgrade, but comes super handy if you are designing for those products. Number 4, they have introduced Figma Chrome extension. Like, you know, there are a lot of meetings that happen around, like, you know, design discussion, brainstorming and things like that. And we keep sharing files over Slack or something else and just adding it to the email. So now you'll be able to add your Figma files as well as Figjam files right inside the Google Calendar invite. Number 5, push notifications. So they have finally added push notifications to their iOS, Android and desktop products. So what it means is, now since you are getting all those emails on Gmail that, hey, someone has made a comment or someone has shared a file, so now you'll get it on your phone as well. I don't know, like, how helpful that is, but obviously more disturbing or more distracting. So you are updated about all the things that are happening. Also, they have extended it slightly bit by introducing comments. So you'll be able to reply to the comments or respond to the comments that people have made on your file. In addition to that, you'll be able to review someone else's work and add comments to it as well. Number 6, so they have finally added video support to prototype. So you can add any sort of videos in your prototype. So instead of using GIFs or images, you'll be able to use videos, and they have also given the same functionality as image, etc., which is you can also control it while you are hovering, while you are scrolling and things like that in the Figma video. Now you will be able to create those stories more realistically that you see on Instagram or any of the coolest interactions that you see where video is playing in the background. So they have extended all sorts of support, and they have discovered a lot more use cases for videos in prototypes. And you can see they have included a playground link for you to play with and test out all the different use cases of video in prototypes. So this is certainly going to be amazing for all those, like, you know, who are designing for OTTs, some streaming platforms, some, like, you know, social media and things like that. So now you can make more realistic prototypes. Number 7, so they have made it easier to build as well as edit prototypes. So now you'll be able to do the same functionality that you have been doing in design. So you'll be able to drag and select multiple interactions and delete it at once, or, like, you know, just link it to another file. Also, they have solved one more problem for all of us. Now you'll be able to create interaction from any side of the frame, instead of just, like, you know, things overlapping on top of each other, which makes it hard to read, like, you know, not legible and also looks like a mess. Now you'll be able to drag out the handle from any side and still create the amazing prototypes that you do. So those were the 7 features from Figma, which they released in October that I really liked. Let me know in the comments that which feature amongst these you like the most. That was all for this video. I will see you in the next video. Till then, happy designing.